kind of been one of those slumps lately where I haven't caught any good fish. You know, I've been struggling on my last few trips. It's been frustrating. So I want to go fishing today, and I want to go catch some. The only problem is my boat's down. So the only thing I've got is my kayak. I just put a set of fresh fins on the Hobes here. And I'm going to get a few rods rigged up and just go fishing, man. Just have one of those days. Like, I've been doing so much other stuff lately, just trying to adjust to being a full-time YouTuber and producer, trying to get all the business stuff straight, that I haven't really been just focusing on me when I go out and I fish. And I'm ready for one of those days again, guys. So I'm going to take you along with me. So I hope we go catch them. Let's hit the lake. We're here. I'm going to play around with a new shot today. I haven't done head cam in a really long time. And I've got a microphone I'm going to somehow like try to stick to my face. When I try to shoot chesty on the kayak, it's just not good for, you know, like seeing everything. It's just kind of right there, and my rod and reel's right there. So I'm gonna put it on the head today. Hopefully it works out. Let me know if you like it. We have definitely got some wind to contend with today. That's all right, I'm up for a challenge. I'm ready for a workout. Try to get our electronics working. I don't know what the crap's going on with that. It keeps cutting on and off. I'm gonna just have to go no electronics today. I figured while I am just moving to a spot here, I'm gonna try to get out of the wind a little bit. I'm gonna do some trolling. All I know is this is freaking hard to do this with all this stuff. Woo! It's gonna be an interesting video today, guys. Hopefully we get one on the line here before too long. Look at that. You see these waves coming over? No big deal. Just slows you down. It's like life. You get waves that slow you down, you just gotta power through. Tell them you're the man. Like, I don't care, waves. You got more? Come on, what's the biggest wave you got? I'm gonna get to my bass. You cannot keep me from my bass. Just got one on the crank. Oh, dang, he came off. That was a good one. I was just pausing there for a moment. I was like, I wonder if I'm hitting the bottom. And I started putting the rod tip down. And as soon as I started making bottom contact, I got a fish right here on this main lake point. An hour later, going beast mode. Beast mode with the legs right now. Almost there. Finally getting to the first area. Just tied on a jig. This is a 3/8 ounce jig, and I got a little crawl trailer on there. One of my favorite things to do is fish trees in the pre and post spawn. So I'm in an area that's got some trees that are on a point. There's no doubt in my mind there's gotta be fish around here. Just gotta slow down. It's actually gonna be pretty good fishing it out of the kayak, so I can get right into the trees, no problem. And then I can just silently dabble around at the base of these old oak trees. So hopefully I get a big bite on this. There he is. Oh, it came off. Dang. Just need to bungee my kayak to this. Oh yeah, now we're in business. I've only got 15 pound test fluorocarbon on here. Kind of scares me around these trees. Kind of scares me just fishing a jig in general. Get some good bites on it, but trolling with what I got, guys. I didn't want to bring my nice beef sticks out here, damage them in this kayak. Oh God, that was a bite. Oh man, I jerked him so hard too. Oh my God. What the heck? It was a bass that just came up right here.
God, just got hammered right there. Oh, dang, it got me hung up. God, this is for sure a fish, guys. All right, we're gonna move up a little bit more shallow water here. This is gonna be a flat here. Should be a good spawning area. It came off. I don't know how, I just missed that fish. Just gonna move on up here in the shallows. See what we got. Well, there's one out of the reeds. No bloody tail. Ah, finally. Up in the dirt. Oh gosh, just had one right there. Did you see it? Did you guys see that? Just grabbed the tail. It wasn't a big one. He's got it again.
Got him.
He's on a bed, for sure. Like, no question. Oh my gosh, there's a fish right here. Right there. That one's definitely spawned out. He's light. So what's going on here? I've got this flat back here, and I'm just slowly starting to drag, flipping these reed areas, and this whole flat is like 2 or 3 feet deep, which is primo spawn and post-spawn flat type territory. So there's gonna be fish moving out on the points, but they slowly make their way out and they follow these little stump fields. And I'm just taking this jig, and a lot of times I'm flipping it to there, and I'm just kind of letting it sit, bounce a little bit, and then just come over and peck it. For some reason, they're not eating it totally. I mean, I've only caught, like, landed two fish. This jig is so tore up. Like, the head of the jigs has teeth marks all over it. My trailer's all tore up. So I should have caught like 8 fish by now, but they're definitely in here. Like I said, I was confident in this area just because it's an in and out area. They're gonna be coming in here to spawn. They're gonna be coming out of here, out of the spawning area. So it's a for sure thing. This is actually a jig that one of you guys sit in, and it's freaking awesome. Well, thank you. Like, this is a very well done jig. I love the color too, love the head. I want you guys to see that. This is a perfect jig. There's a shallow stump right there. Love to get bites that close. Oh, there we go. Yeah, it's coming right out. Yeah, nice. Another skinny post spawn fish. Take them all. There's one. Got it right there. Ate it. Ah, so close, I couldn't fight him. Smacked the crap out of it. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We got 6 boats back here now. Started off with 2. Obviously, my spot choice was good. Took me a long time to get over here, but I'm just having connection issues today. Having problems getting them in. That last one, I would have never had that fish been in a bass boat because it was so close. Like, it's just the stealthiness of the kayak is what, you know, it allows you to sneak up on those bass. It's pretty awesome. I mean, the jig, it's just good for quality bites. I'm hoping to get like a 4 or 5 pounder at least. This is the thing that sucks about a kayak, because like you can't just pick it up and, okay, I'm gonna head over here. You gotta really think about it, kind of dedicate to where you wanna fish. Holy cow, guys. Good. Thanks. People are wondering what the hell I'm doing out here in the middle of the lake. Two-foot waves in a kayak. Kind of wondering the same thing myself. You know, some of you guys ask why I don't wear a life jacket when I'm kayak fishing. It's probably a valid question right now. I've drifted over to a pocket. It's got a ton of trees in it. I've never actually gone in there with a bass boat because it's so gnarly. But today I've got a kayak. Seems like a good thing to do. Maybe there'll be some bass back here. We're gonna find out. There's a better one right there. That's a better one. Come here, baby. That's a better fish. Yeah. There we go. There's a jig fish, guys. Still not slamming it, but that's a healthy one right there. Look how fat that one is. That's a nice one. All right, baby. I enjoyed that. Oh, that's a better one. Come here. Yeah, there we go. Come here. There we go. Another jig fish, baby. God, I love catching them on that jig, man. Love the way they hit it. It's a decent one right there. Gotta get a good smell in. Oh, God, you smell so good. Like sweet honey grass. See ya, darling. Yeah. You just gotta love that, guys. Gotta love it. Hit the like button for the dedication. Traveling across these nasty waters in the kayak. Sometimes you just gotta have no fear. Just go. Just go on a windy day. Woo! There he is. Feisty. There's one. Got him. That's a good one. Come here, baby. Feisty. Oh, such a good bite. Just dun, dun. right up there in that probably 2 feet of water. I love getting jig bites up close where it's like just close quarters combat. You get that thwoom, you set the hook and it's just, everything's just right there raw and real up close where you can see everything. Whew, it's money, love it. I don't know what the heck that was, but that just broke me off. Oh boy. Oh, he broke me off. Dang. That was a tasty one right there. Yep. He had me on something. It was not gonna work out. How's that looking? I think that looks pretty awesome. Got one on here. Oh my God. Dang. Still on. There he goes. I got him. Yes. Yes. Gosh, gonna be wrapped on that tree, but I didn't really pull hard this time. I made that mistake a few minutes ago, so I just let him kind of run, and eventually he worked his way out. Love you. Got lucky. There he is. Come here. Oh yeah, he tagged it. Another one on that jig. He ate it good. So guys, what's going on here is we've got a staging area, spawning flat, and all these trees are just leading into this area. It's similar to where I was at before, except there's a lot more trees now. The fish will get at the base of these oak trees, or these old trees, whatever they are. Some of them are cypress. That guy's hooked really good. Look how much he wanted that. So they'll move up onto this flat, and what I found back there is it's a hard bottom. It's hard sand, and then there's some shell mix in, so it's a perfect spawning area. I know some of them are spawning, but some of them aren't. And they're just kind of, they're like all stages moving in here. All right, so I've caught a lot of fish around these trees. I've had some pretty good bites, I feel like, that have gotten away. I don't know. They could have been maybe up to 5 pounds, but they could have been 3 or 4. You just never know. Up there shallow in that 2 to 5 feet of water, and I've had some out there in 6 to 8 too. Just no giants. Just no giants. Had to find the inner bear strength today. Get through those waves, get up this incline, this big ass kayak. I really needed this video today, guys, because I was kind of in a slump and my boat was broken down. You know, I was getting it tuned up, my trolling motor broke the other day, so I really just needed to come out here and catch some fish, and I got on that decent jig bite. So if you guys want to check out the trailers I was using, I didn't go into them a whole lot. I'll put a link for them in the description. They're two of my favorite trailers I use like all year round. So caught some good fish on that jig today, guys. Anywhere from 2 to like 8 feet of water, I would say. All things going on, like spawn, post-spawn, you know, pre-spawn, it was all there, but all the fish were kind of going in and out of the same areas. There were some out deep that I obviously couldn't get to. I had to pedal. My legs are so tired right now, guys. I have like dead legs from paddling so much today. So go ahead and hit the like button for a little extra effort today, and show me a little fishing love, man. If you hadn't subscribed to the channel yet, come on over, hit that button. It's free. and we do the fishing thing all the time. Can't wait to get on the water next when the boat's fixed, guys, and I'll catch you on the next video.